Hello, Petey.
And we will make it out of here.
How's everybody doing?
Did you get changed in the car?
I did.
You must have got ready quick.
That's right.
But Pete, it's 1:45.
It is.
You must be a little late.
When I was talking to April, and I had breakfast too. The reason I was late.
That's so ironic. I watched Wedding Singer this week.
Again, information I could have used yesterday.
That's funny. This is it, the big day. These are the official pieces of paper that we have to. You want me to take this back?
Yeah, we'll get it from you.
Yeah, I'll take it back with me. I can do that. I can do that. So we'll have that there. And this here that I need to sign as well.
Parents don't sign anything.
They don't.
You can if you want. No, I want you used to sign my signature on my checks.
Yeah. pleasure to welcome you here this afternoon for this exciting day that we're sharing together. And on behalf of the bride, I'd just like to share a few announcements as we begin. There's to be no confetti or rice thrown in the church. However, wedding bubbles will be provided for everyone following the ceremony, and you can blow bubbles till you burst after the ceremony. Photographs to be taken only by the photographer, please, during the ceremony. There will most likely not be a receiving line unless the rain cuts out on us, and reception at Rod's Travel Lodge at 6:30 this evening. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church. This holy estate, Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee, and the Apostle Paul commended as honorable among all men. It is not therefore to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Love is and will continue to be important between Paul and April, and so at this time, Christina Campbell is coming to share a few words about love from the Word of God.
Love is kind and patient, never jealous, boastful, proud, or rude. Love isn't selfish or quick-tempered. It doesn't keep a record of wrongs that others do. Love rejoices in the truth, but not in evil. Love is always supportive, loyal, hopeful, and trusting. Love never fails.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man? I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. No other human ties are more tender, no other vows more sacred than those you now assume. If these solemn vows be faithfully kept, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, your life be full of joy, and the home you are establishing will abide in peace. Paul Leblanc, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
April Jenkins, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live? Paul, if you'd repeat after me. I, Paul, take you, April. To be my wedded wife, to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
till death do us part,
till death do us part,
according to God's holy law,
according to God's holy law,
and thereto I pledge you my faith,
and thereto I pledge you my faith.
I, April, take you, Paul.
I, April, take you, Paul.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And thereto I pledge you my faith. Do you wish to have these vows sealed with the gift of rings? We have here to be given by each to the other these golden circlet has been from time beyond measure the symbol of wedded love. The unending circle of the ring suggests the endlessness of real love. The purity of the precious metal suggests the purity of the married state as it is lived in accordance with the will and laws of God. As often as you both shall see it, may it bring to memory this single glad moment when two lives become one. Take it and place it on her hand. On the third finger of the left hand, if you can find it. The like token will be given by the bride to the groom as it shall surround his finger. May it betoken love and joy and peace, surrounding and binding together both your lives. Take it and place it on his hand. For as much as Paul and April have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and have thereto pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Now this traditionally, ladies and gentlemen, is the time in the ceremony where the groom has an opportunity to kiss his bride. And for those of you who were here at the rehearsal last evening, you know that Paul is ready for this moment. But Paul, there's a little surprise we have for you. That perhaps only April, myself, and a very few others know about. And you see, it's very important, as I did your premarital counseling, Paul, you weren't completely honest with me about one particular area in your relationship. And as April and I discussed this, we felt it'd be very appropriate that before you would be allowed to kiss her, now some of you may not fully understand this, please feel free to ask, but several of you, I understand, will. Now, I understand as a matter of an Irish Spring soapbox. That you have refused to put in the garbage, to be obedient and submit to your wife. Now, as your first act of servant leadership in your home, we would like, before you kiss your bride, for you to place this. Do we have a
ceremonial garbage can?
I'll tell you what, we will let... We'll let the just over the altar rail here pass as kind of a garbage area. So this is for you. This is the ceremonial act of servant leadership in the home. Thank you so much for putting your garbage away. And marriage is more than a legal contract, but rather a bond of union sealed in heaven. Henceforth, you shall no longer be two, but one. Your paths will be united. Your responsibilities will increase, but your strength and your joys will be multiplied if you are sincere and earnest in your relations one to the other, and with God, who has witnessed and sealed this covenant. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you that we can gather in such a place to offer worship to you as we raise again the standard of the institution of marriage. We thank you that you have created this wonderful, beautiful bond, this symbol of the relationship between you and your church. And we thank you, Lord, for the love that you have placed in Paul and April's hearts for each other that has brought us together here this afternoon. And I thank you, Lord, for the beautiful and bright future that you have for them and for their future family. Lord, we just ask together, in the name of Jesus, that you would bless their home and that you would guide them together as they spend the rest of their lives loving each other with the strength only you can give. In your precious and holy name, amen. Wouldn't miss this.
Thank you so much.
Now, listen, it's all over. We introduce you, and we party for the rest of the day.
Right.
So what we're going to do, now, I'm not sure where your photographer is.
Yeah, she's coming around.
Okay, but what we're going to do now, we need to kind of get this table in place. You each only sign once, and we'll wait till she gets here, because we got all kinds of time.
There's just, Paul, you'll stand behind me, right? Isn't that how you
do? Yeah, that's normally. So let's maybe pull this, even angle it a bit like that. Perfect, perfect.
So
you will sign right there.
Okay.
Now, however you want us to kind of pose for this.
Okay, well, she can just all of a sudden just look up at me. All three of you look up at me. Right? One more like that, make sure you didn't blink.
It's so much better than doing it out there in front of everybody.
Yeah.
I can watch everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Last time, kid.
There it is.
Woo-hoo!
Don't want to
hurt. Yeah, don't go there.
Okay, don't go there.
Okay, any more pictures you want just with them?
Sure.
He's writing or anything.
Alright, I think your eyes were all open for that one, but just in case. Wonderful.
Now go ahead and sign on the line there.
Sign your life away.
Okay, now we need Marie up here and Rob.
Yep.
So.
Well, that was really fast.
It was quick, wasn't it?
Alrighty, step right up. Did you want him in the.
Yep, put the.
Okay,
the best
sign.
The best
people.
28. Okay, ready? More like that.
We gotta get somebody to go home with a checkbook and pay Terrence. He might like to get paid.
He might.
And do you
you can pay me whenever you get
like when you're done.
Pictures.
Okay, yeah.
They are they're done out there. That's fine. We'll just kinda
can we do it again?
One more here.
Right.
Yeah, right down underneath Marie's signature there, yeah. And I'll sign mine.
Can I just look up at me for a second?
Look up,
Rob.
Look up.
Okay, pretend you're still signing. Okay, now look up at me. Oh, one more.
He's even got the wiggle going. Blinks.
One more like this. Okay, you're going to be tired.
The feathers look
hilarious.
Yeah.
That's great, folks. That's it. All right. Okay, all right. Now back in the same order.
Where is some?
Congratulations, man.
Thank you, buddy. Couldn't have done it without you. All your support. What?
Well, it's all fun and games.
We're going to go out and call it Christmas.
Oh, thank you. Nobody's saying anything about us.
Thank you.
break your camera.
Thank you very much, Uncle Evie. Uncle Freddy, thank you.
Yeah, we're not done yet.
I know, this is the beginning. That's what I'm afraid of.
Today is just beginning.
I know. I know. I can't even wait.
Is it recording? What's the flashing light do?
Isn't it fun when people do that too, yeah?
Official, I think it's really about time that some of you guys return your keys to Abel's place.
girls at the head table, my daughters, ate her Taylor and Glenn. Now, I always get them all mixed up. Taylor and Glenn Jenkins. Next to them, Krista Moore. Heidi Stevenson.
Come on!
Ah!
Hazelbrook, right? And I mean, there are whips all the time. We went up and had a little party, and being calm and collective, and you know, not being nervous at all. It was a great weekend. I just wanted you guys to know, like, all the girls, that these guys were great. They were clean. They didn't try to cause me problems. And when they're in the fires, like, they were really nice to the staff and all the people that attended the fire. And when the police stopped us in the car, I just wanted you all, you know, you were calm and you know, being the collective one I am, and so excited to come to Paul's wedding. I said, control the situation and didn't freak out at all. No. Anyway, I just wanted to say that congratulations to Paul and April. You guys are quite a couple. And you didn't do anything bad on that weekend.
It was, okay.
My sister, being as gullible and naive as she was, had a crush on him. So the poor guy, she used to call him up every night. Hey, Bob, how are you? You're so cool. I like you. And eventually I got tired of this because I needed to use the phone, being the youngest that I was, like dad on the phone with everybody. So I grabbed the phone from my sister and said, leave that guy alone. We played hockey together and stuff. And I said, so I grabbed the phone from her. Hey, listen, sorry, man. Sorry, that's my sister. And I'm really sorry. Hey, yeah, that's okay. Then there's a big pause of silence. Hey, want to sleep over? Then Paul's like, well, I've got a Commodore 64 and a television. Hey, we'll sleep at your place and play video games. So, at any rate, I played video games and he kicked my butt. You know, he smelled a little bit of stuff. I thought he was a pretty cool guy, so we ended up being good buddies. And it's been, what, 15, 16 years, and love him to death. But the reason I tell that story is being the best friend that he is, and I love him to death. I only want the best for him, and I think April is that best that he deserves. And I just want to say congratulations and all the best. Now, smooch. Thank you.
was nonchalantly standing there, minding my own business while he proceeded to tell me what to do myself. Repeatedly, over and over and over and over. I wasn't really paying attention. I was talking to one of the other guys, but Paul caught wind of this. Instead of you talking to me, and then proceeded to wail on this guy's head. I believe the blows was exchanged towards myself, but Paul, as being a good friend, proceeded to defend my honor. And I would just like to thank you for that. And I appreciate that very much for taking care of me.
bridesmaids are very beautiful. Thank you very much for everything you've done. You're looking so incredible. Actually, I would like everyone to give them a standing ovation for their beauty. Look, your buddy.
Leblanc.
He's got two boys, and he's a very calm, cool, reserved
I love you, Angel. I love you, man.
I was thinking back, you know, thanks probably to one person in this room more than anybody will be my mother, Mom Nancy, that got us all together. Because if it wasn't for her, we wouldn't be down there, and Angel wouldn't be there. And then it's a funny thing the way everything goes, but it all works out in the end. And I hope we have a lot of good years ahead of us and a lot of golf. And please bring Rob with you. I just, only for golf, no other reason. His temperament on the golf course is second to none. His enjoyment of the game, his enthusiasm for it, he embraces every detail of the course. Every stroke is a challenge. He enjoys it so much. And you brought that into my life, and I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Everybody is up here in the corner, just make themselves comfortable, stand up, walk around, do whatever. don't be shy. I know a lot of you out there have stories that you can tell over microphone. So please feel free to come up and share some of them with us. Thank you.
Yeah. song. And it's a real special song. And it's called April Showers. And so when you hear this song from now on, April, you'll think of this, okay? Now, if I can get the music going the right way, because it's really tough to get to.
Thank you.
Who's